That's News Center.
Right now on the Weather Channel, your local forecast.
Joining us for WeatherScope, I'm Janetta Jones and Bill Keneally. And by the way, Merry Christmas to everyone. Hope you're having a good Christmas Eve. The weather is not that great, but as we were discussing earlier, I'm sure the kids are jumping up and down and rejoicing for the snow.
The weather outside is frightful.
Yes.
That's what you're trying to say. But
yes,
the kids think it's pretty darn delightful.
Exactly.
But you're all bedecked in green. You're in
yes.
the holiday spirit.
Yes.
And hopefully everybody's done with their shopping in the Eastern time zone. The only thing available now are probably lumps of coal for the stocking, I say.
Oh, I hope I don't get that.
Me neither. That was pretty good today. Well, I've had better days. In any event, though, we have some pictures of snow, JJ, to talk about. Take you to Chicago, Illinois. And in the Chicagoland area, we had rain for a couple hours, and it decided it wanted to go over to snow. Even Mother Nature was in the holiday spirit. Check out the size of these flakes coming down. They did get heavier, and they still are pretty heavy in the Chicagoland. Topeka, Kansas, our next stop. You can see the ground definitely whitened. The roadways are slushy, and anywhere from 2 to 4 inches of snow has fallen in the Topeka, Lawrence, and Kansas City corridor. Although I think the worst of it probably behind you from the falling precipitation aspect, but as far as temperatures go, they will be falling as well. You can see the slushy nature of the roads there in northeastern Kansas and I-70 as well as the Kansas Turnpike. But there's still an upper low hung way back here, so it's going to still be residual snow falling. Nothing real heavy, nothing like we've seen earlier. We've had reports of 6 to 8 inches of snow in Marion County, southeast of Des Moines, Iowa. Still some pretty good snow falling, especially north and west of the Chicagoland, also Milwaukee and Madison, as you get up into the Badgerland, that area getting some pretty good snow as well. Rain and sleet pretty much in evidence in the Detroit metro. We may go over to rain for a while, but then I think everything starts to pull slowly back eastward, and we should go over to snow in Motown overnight tonight. Well, the upper low is back here, right on the border of Illinois and Indiana, right there in the Wabash Valley. As that low moves overhead, that'll help to start pulling the colder air in aloft, at least. So Chicagoland should stay pretty much snow from here on out. But just to reiterate, looks like Detroit, as that low pulls overhead, will probably turn over to snow. All the while, warm air heading up the coast. However, there's quite a cloak or a mantle of white around Boston. A lot of snow fell yesterday. Cold air may be trapped in the valleys for a while, so watch out traveling. Early tomorrow morning around 128 and especially 495 in the Merrimack Valley, but eventually even southern New Hampshire should go over to some rain. Michigan now seeing the rain and the sleet. mixing in with more snow as you get out here in southwestern lower Michigan. All snow, Milwaukee, Madison, into the Chicagoland area. Let's take you on in again around Detroit, Port Huron, Flint, a mixture of rain and sleet, a mixture of rain, sleet, and snow farther west out through Holland, Grand Rapids, and Battle Creek. And then pretty much a snow event in Chicago, although we're getting a couple of holes in the snowpack, or the snowfall, I should say, west of about the Elgin area and to near Rockford, but still a fairly steady snow in Cook County and DuPage County. Lake County, westward, that's going to be where the heavier accumulating snow is, but some drier air, thankfully, starting to punch in around Gary, Indiana. But this whole system is still not really pulling eastward anytime soon, so our call for the snow from here on out, 3 to 6 inches, Lake and McHenry County, through Rockford, Freeport, to the northern Quad Cities. Heavier snows around Janesville, Beloit, over to Lake Geneva and Milwaukee, and also pretty good snow north and west of Grand Rapids, out to about Muskegon, could see 6 inches, and decent snow expected into the Adirondacks in Vermont, New Hampshire, and Maine. That is through noontime Tuesday. Why? Well, we think a secondary low is going to develop and then push up to Cape Cod, help the cold air to be, hold the cold air in with that northeast wind. So even though we're expecting a transition to rain in Boston, Providence, and probably Hartford, that will not be the case in the mountain areas in Vermont, New Hampshire, and Maine. The other angle has been the rain. Thankfully, drier westerly winds coming in now. Still some rain in North Florida, but earlier today, the Gulf Coast really inundated. 4.43 inches of rain at Biloxi, and at the bottom of the list, Meridian 2.25, Atlanta 2.25 as well. Atlanta drying out, a couple of sprinkles out by Covington and Conyers. Heavier rains, though, into North Florida. Let's take it down around the Tampa Bay area now, north of Pinellas County, up towards, actually around Brooksville and Inverness, and into the open Gulf. That is where the heavier rain is. Heading to the Carolinas and Virginia and Maryland, that is all rain. Even the mountain areas, all rainfall now. Heaviest of rain, Charleston to Savannah, heading to the northeast. Lightning strikes, they're out there too. Use caution, any boaters in the Georgia and Florida coastal waters especially. Another system chugging along in the west. And for details, here's Janetta.
Thanks, Bill. A new system is beginning to move into the west, but you're not feeling the effects of it just yet. Those of you in the northwest had to deal with something a little different. It wasn't an easy day for a game of golf. There were a few sprinkles early in the morning, but fog has persisted in places like Fort Lewis. At least it did throughout much of the day. At times, visibility was below a quarter of a mile, and temperatures were only in the 30s, making it a cold day to be out and about. Oh, my, now that is dedication. Get out there in that fog and try and play golf. All right, let's check it out. In the west, we have a new storm system that is going to be plowing on through the southwest. It's already there. We're already seeing the snow in places like the White Mountains of Arizona, some rain for you in Tucson, and we're going to see the snow continuing to plow on into the higher elevations of New Mexico and Colorado. So do expect some fresh new powder on those slopes in Colorado before you head out to do some snow skiing for this holiday. And there you see it, the snow in the higher elevations, a little bit of rain for you there in Tucson. Snow is going to be venturing on out into Albuquerque, New Mexico. And we do have some heavy snow warnings and snow advisories in effect for these areas, especially the higher elevations. And that does include portions of Colorado. Do expect the snow. Going to be a few problem areas for you there on I-70. Not to mention I-80. The snow does extend on into Goodland, Kansas, not to mention Concordia. And you can see it there on our surface map, the snow persisting. So a lot of folks going to see a white Christmas, and I know that makes you very happy. Hopefully you can just settle in and throw another log on the fire and enjoy the view, right? Hopefully you're not having to be out there trudging through it in your car with the snow chains on. A little bit of fog still a problem in parts of Washington State and Oregon. The temperature is 40 right now in Portland, 56 in San Francisco, and in the 60s in Los Angeles and San Diego. So no problems on the PCH for all of you travelers. Just watch out for the other guy, right? Checking out the current surface map, this is pretty much the big game in town with all of that precipitation heading on towards the north and the east just in time for Christmas Day. As Bill was alluding to, we do have that possibility of some frozen precipitation in parts of New York State and southern Vermont, southern New Hampshire, and maybe even into Portland, Maine. Looks like we're going to see it move fairly quickly, though, moving away from Detroit and right on through into northern Maine by tomorrow afternoon. We may